Greg Herbold, age 34, occupation, retired mountain bike factory honcho.
How long have you lived out here?
Been here at the ranch a couple years, and in that 2 year time, I have about 10 kilometers of trails, 25 jumps, about 17 berms, 5 or 6 ditches of death. They're all named, they're all ready to go. Hey, Dad!
What?
Check out my launcher of love, dude!
Oh, oh, oh. Now, you're retired?
Retired, not retarded. Yeah, I know, there comes a time in a guy's life when he needs to hang up the chamois. And
why?
Been doing the pro thing for 10 years, you know, I won the world championships, been to national camp 3 times, and just decided I wanted to stay home, hang out on the ranch, grow some trout.
Yeah.
Pet the poodle a little bit.
Hey, leave your personal life out of this, buddy, because, you know, I don't need to hear about the poodle. But how long have you been riding a bike?
I didn't start racing until 5, right? So, right. And I did the little BMX thing, you know, hippity-hoppity, right?
Did you really?
Yeah,
how old were when you did the BMX stuff?
I guess I started when I was 8.
Yeah?
You know, shredded around until I was about 15 and kind of found girls, and that sort of screwed up my racing career there for a while.
Nothing wrong with that.
I started racing when I was 9 years old. My uncle showed up at my house with a bike and said, hey, let's go down to the track. And I've been racing, you know, 15 years now. There's not really much of a professional scene out in Ohio, so I moved out to California after I graduated from high school. And you're gonna be a professional BMX racer or freestyle or whatever. Southern California is where you need to be. I live with Brian Foster. And he's got a brother, Alan Foster. They're the only brother combination that are racing pro right now. You know, you don't mention Alan without mentioning Brian, and vice versa. You know, they're the Foster brothers.
Todd is indeed the wild man. You think he's just completely on the edge and gonna kill himself, but
he pulls all the tricks, he pulls all the stuff, and he races. And he even wins some races sometimes.
Somehow he lands on 2 wheels and rides away from it.
But man, he's loose.
I just have a knack of going all out all the time, and I tend to crash a lot of people racing, and I'm usually the last person that anyone wants to be next to on the gate or in the turn, because if I'm next to him, I'm usually messing somebody up. I do have, I'd say, more fun than most other people. You know, there's a lot more to me than just racing. I'm not the type of guy that goes out there and wins races and gets the crowd support that way, so I'm usually doing something silly.
We started doing backflips a couple years ago, like 2 years ago. We were at a race and there was a good double down the back straight, and it was nice and wide open, and he was doing flips.
He did a couple in a race, and BMXers had never seen that before, so they were just freaking out.
And I just couldn't believe it.
It was a pretty big deal, you know, nobody had ever done a backflip in a race or in competition, so it was pretty fun. I think I had more people talking to me and signing more autographs there than probably anywhere else.
It's 12 o'clock, we're having a barbecue. They are gonna be there, and ladies, I wanna see you. We'll be.
What are you eating?
I'm a turkey burger.
Oh, here, you want some cheese on that turkey burger?
No, I want
a.
Is that your hamburger?
Yeah. Okay, let me.
Nothing like power in a burger, huh?
No, you don't eat them, you just put them in your mouth. You try to like place them in there, you're gonna see how many you can shove in your mouth with the Coke and say Fuzzy Bunny.
You know, I think you just wanna see me shove marshmallows in my mouth.
Fuzzy Bunny! Drink a Coke!
Can you throw it this far? No! Oh. Here, give me another one. No! Oh.
Dan, get it together, buddy.
Oh, sorry.
Feels late.
Be part of the magic all over again.
Pee-pee for your bunghole.
MTV is proud to announce brand new episodes of Beavis and Butthead. See how they've grown, what they've learned.
Spermophytal lubricant. Ribbed for her pleasure.
As we roll out exciting new adventures.
And we're gonna get some beer. It's really gonna happen.
All this week at 11:30. All new Beavis and Butthead. Because nothing can stay the same forever. Well, almost nothing.
MTV Sports is brought to you by Reebok. Are you prepared to say, this is my planet? And by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
So it's your first day at work, and are you ever working?
Ma'am.
Skinny double half-cup latte with extra foam.
Americano. Extra water.
Twix gives you chewy caramel, milk chocolate, and that great cookie crunch twice.
You all sell coffee here?
I'm after Twix.
Some people say I've got too much on my mind. Movies, music, toys. Correction. There's only one thing in my head. The championship. The championship. Because I got 10 fingers and no rings. And I love jewelry. That's what's on my mind. This is my planet.
You got room for a brother on your planet. Fight!
Every few years, the world gathers to witness an unparalleled sports spectacle. The Truckathlon.
Connor, please.
You have to have a Ford Ranger 4x4.
Call Hung Fats and tell him we don't want to sit outside under a string of dead chickens. Man's a car.
It's four-wheel anti-lock brakes for truck.
With all due respect to your psychic abilities, we'll stick to the game plan. All posts, take your positions.
Can't win without one.
Next event, truck pole vault.
Yes!
Big Mac extra value meal, please.
Garcia drops back, singles to Johnson. Whoa! Johnson pivots to Baker, who passes to Garcia. Garcia steps up.
That was quick. Thanks.
It's good!
We're Team McDonald's, official break of the Olympic Games.
Wow! Let's look at a replay from overhead.
Six men have 3 hours.
You don't believe me. What are you doing up here?
Who else is gonna do it? You?
To board and rescue Flight 343, 5 miles above the Earth, because on March 15th, it's coming down.
You have your orders. Execute them.
One way or another, Kurt Russell and Steven Seagal.
We're not gonna make it!
You are!
Executive Decision, rated R. Starts Friday, March 15th at a theater near you.
So it's your first day at work, and are you ever working?
Ma'am.
Skinny double half-cup latte with extra foam.
Americano. Extra water.
Twix gives you chewy caramel, milk chocolate, and that great cookie crunch twice.
You all sell coffee here?
I'm after Twix.
When it comes to the music of the 90s, anything goes.
Right here, right now.
Music today is everywhere. No need to label it. If it's good, we'll play it.
That's why we got Living in the 90s. 2.5 hours of the coolest songs on 2 CDs and 2 cassettes.
Check it out.
When I think about you, I touch myself.
Can't touch this.
Would walk 500 miles next to me, baby. Ice, ice, baby. Life is a highway.
I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my shirts.
There's only one thing left to say about living in the 90s.
You're unbelievable.
To order, call the number on your screen or send check or money order. 2 CDs, $26.99. 2 cassettes, $21.99. Rush delivery available. Living in the 90s is not sold in stores.
Bike guy, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm
total bike
guy.
Did you ever think? Did you ever think that you'd like be riding a bike for a living?
No, not until I was, 19 and realized I could.
How long were you a pro BMX?
I think just 1 year.
How do you make the switch from the BMX to the mountain bike? Was it a big jump?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
BMX is 30, 40 second race.
Right.
And the cross country racing that I do in mountain biking is 2 to 3 hours of endurance riding, so it's a big change.
Sheep Hills is our local spot.
It's the premier Southern California jumping grounds. It's the place that's in all the magazines. Any kid, anywhere, you go to Ohio and if a kid rides, he He's never been to California, but you ask him about sheep hills and he knows about it.
Sheep Hills is just the spot that everyone digs and makes the jumps better, so we can be prepared for any jumps that they're gonna have at the races. Because Sheep Hills is way harder than any of the tracks we ride.
The feeling of riding Sheep Hills, just hitting those sections smooth and just flowing, it's you can't replace that feeling with anything else.
The racing part's kind of a sidebar. That's what supports me and that's what gets me through it all, but riding the trails is what keeps me psyched on it, because that's the funnest part.
Just about any interview with anyone, if they ask, you know, whose style do you like, you know, it's always the Foster Brothers, you know, the Foster Brothers, yeah.
When we were younger, we used to race, and I used to beat him every time. He wasn't even really a threat. Then when he first turned pro, he beat me a couple times, and it sort of shocked me. I was like, man, I can't let my little brother beat me.
Gates down, Ryan Foster, out in front.
He's my brother and everything, but as far as the competition, he is the enemy. I got to beat him, too.
See, Brian Foster, the little brother,
he's a guy with, like, more skills than just about anyone else. I mean, on the track, at the trails, anywhere you go, he's usually doing stuff that nobody else even thinks of, you know? He just got that natural ability.
I ended up number 3 for the year. My brother's number 9. We both plan on stepping that up a couple notches. Alan's the tenacious one out of the both of us.
Alan's not quite as fast as Brian down the straightaways, but Alan is just as good with coming from behind. And
things have come kind of easy to me.
Alan puts a lot of time and effort in his riding. He's at the gym, he's out doing sprints at night.
And then he kept at it, and he's there today.
This jump, I've never flipped it, so we'll see how it goes. It's pretty steep. Should throw me up for a pretty good flip. I think I want to do a few more though.
Wild, man. That was it. That was the flip I was looking for. Oof. Need to do those more often.
Okay, who got the most there? Time out for you, buddy. Nepal, first off, how do you spell it? Big N, little E, big P, A-L. Why were you in Nepal? Just for fun?
No, we went over to film Retrek. It's a feature mountain bike movie that's going to be out in the spring.
Really?
And we just
scored. Is that starring Richard Grieco?
Richard Grieco and Jeff Gillooly.
Oh, of course. Yeah, I love Gillooly.
That guy can ride.
How was the weather in Nepal?
It was like this.
Nice.
It was
really?
Amazing. Yeah, it was like 75 and sunny.
Was that the first time you'd ever been over?
Yeah. It was worlds away.
Bill Snyder is a cinematographer, producer, director, and he's done some really great stuff. Seen a lot of his work in different commercials and whatnot, but a couple years ago he did the first feature-length mountain bike film, and it was called Tread. Successful enough that he decided to come out with the sequel, Retread.
Tread 2.
Tread was based on action. As it turned out, people wanted to know about who the riders were, where they were riding. The culmination, I guess, of that change is this trip to Nepal.
This city is like the gauntlet. I mean, it's insane riding around the streets.
They're moving through alleyways and corridors and all this stuff is whizzing, coming at the camera the way it's coming at the rider.
Are we ready to go?
Let's do it.
It's coming from the side.
Yeah, stay back.
It's coming from the back.
Yeah, like about where Doug is.
There's just so much traffic and bikes and people and rickshaws and trucks and buses. You're breathing diesel and you're just, it's crazy, but it's a rush.
Stop for a second. I'm going to change lenses.
I don't think I was in that.
Bill decided to go more the route with the typical Joe like myself that has a job but really enjoys mountain biking and kind of actually lives to do it.
And I think that's what myself and Perry bring to this film is we just love having a great time and the mountain bike happens to be the means through which we enjoy ourselves.
Everybody ready? Okay, and action!
Bill has been a bike rider for a long, long time. It's a passion of his. It enables him to get into a position where he's capturing subtle things on film that someone that didn't have his background would not be able to capture.
Yeah, you get a lot of great rushes when you catch some air or get a good single track and you're just roosting it, but it's more about doing something you love to do and being in places that you love to be.
That's a hell of a hat that you're wearing. It goes real well with the earring. Five through the nose, bold and daring. You got to pardon me if I'm scaring.
So much area and so much rugged terrain. It's very, very cool.
Okay, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we're going. Rolling.
Take one.
Okay, and watch your shadow. Go.
Nepal is an amazing place. Being on a bike, you're interacting, you're traveling within their environment. You're not passing through it in a vehicle that kind of cuts you off. You know, not only is it just beautiful naturally, but, you know, it's a rare experience to go almost as if you've been traveling in a time machine and get back to these a completely different way of life.
Hey, it's downhill time.
A lot of times it's great because you come down something and you're just on the edge of control and you get down and you just start laughing to yourself and you can't believe you actually made it down in one piece.
We, the jury in the above entitled action, find a defendant, Calvin Brodus, not guilty of the crime of murder in the second
degree. The verdict is in. Now it's Snoop's turn to speak out in an MTV exclusive interview.
How can I be happy about somebody being dead? This touched me, you know what I'm saying? I'm not one about taking lives, I'm about saving lives.
Hear it straight from the dog's mouth.
All the violence is behind us now. It's all behind us. We got to look forward to 97.
Snoop Raw, Part 2, an MTV News in-depth interview, Wednesday at 4:30 and 7:30.
MTV Sports is brought to you by Reebok. Are you prepared to say, this is my planet? And by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
What a difference.
This is what makes Monday different from Tuesday.
24 little.
This is what makes me any age I want to be. And this is the way I want my daughter to think of me. Strong, active, and not just awake, but alive. This is my freedom. This is my planet.
If you're up early enough to have the road to yourself, driving can actually be fun.
My hot rod days are over, but I'm still more likely to pass than to be passed.
Sometimes on the weekends, my husband and I just like to kind of take off and lose ourselves in the beautiful scenery. If he's driving,
left.
West.
That way.
You're.
That's very easy.
Honey!
Ford Contour, a world car for your world. Well equipped for just $15,190.
We are here today to talk about tomorrow. Yesterday is gone, and tomorrow will soon be today. And seems like only yesterday when I was sitting.
Turn it up! Turn up the juice! The juice!
You are the wave of the future.
Turn up the juice!
Starburst fruit juice with real fruit juice.
From Touchstone Pictures, Art Dodge is about to discover when it comes to romance, two sisters.
Isn't he adorable?
Yeah. Is one too many.
You're gonna look so good with me up at the altar.
Fabulous idea!
Have you ever been married?
Antonio Banderas.
I think I need an aspirin.
Melanie Griffith. Daryl Hannah. Too much.
Everything's all straightened out for you.
Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, March 15th.
We're here to tell you about Abworks from Nordic Track, the advanced abdominal exerciser.
Abworks is fun, it's new, and it's hot. Get Abworks for a smoking new waistline.
Abworks by Nordic Track.
With Abworks, you can effectively work your abs with complete neck and back support.
Look better. Sculpt the abs of your dreams. The ultimate ab machine is here. Abworks by Nordic Track. Work upper, lower, and side abdominals with complete support for the head, neck, and spine for a safe workout. Tone your entire waistline in just 5 minutes a day. Get it for $119.95 or four easy payments of $29.95.
Call now to order and get this free workout video with complete instructions for 15 Abworks exercises, plus my 20-minute aerobic workout. That's everything you need.
Call now to order the complete ab work system for $119.95 or four easy payments of $29.95. Get your ab works today.
Every day, America Online is making it a little easier for people to live, work, and play. With point-and-click access to instant news and sports, financial updates, online magazines, shopping and travel, and easy access to the Internet. Call now for America Online, a new way to use your computer to communicate and have fun.
Call 1-800-231-3100 for your free America Online Startup Kit with free software and 10 free online hours. It's everything you need to get online. Call now.
So you got your Richie Cunningham bike?
Yes. Sir,
that's right.
Ready to go.
I've got the Potsy Weber model.
This is a little combination bike between a mountain bike and your road racing machine.
How did you start with the cyclocross? How'd you get into it?
I got into the cross to help my mountain biking skills, and basically it's just really an awesome sport. It's kind of a cult sport underground. There's not a lot of people into it.
How do you train for it?
You go to the races, and that's pretty much the training.
Right.
There's a local series I'm doing in Santa Cruz, and so there's a couple hundred people that arrive on the weekend, and you rip around a course at warp speed, high intensity, with your heart coming out of your throat.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
Hi, my name's Sherry Kane.
I'm Daryl Price.
I'm Travis Brown.
And we're here on the California coast.
Santa Cruz, California.
We're doing the Surf City Cyclocross Series.
Prepping for the U.S. National Championship.
What the heck is this? These people
those
running?
Those rocks are made for riding, huh?
What's the guy do carrying that bike on his shoulder for?
Something wrong with that boy.
One, two, three.
The sport of cyclocross involves a lot of running.
You can't ride all the course, and you can't run all the course.
You have barriers that you're jumping over.
You've got a mixture of pavement, dirt.
There are sections that force you to get off, and run with your bike.
Maybe climbing over a hill, descending through a hill.
Shouldering your bike, running over obstacles.
There's a lot of close racing, which makes it exciting. One of the most important things in cyclocross is getting on and off your bike and getting through the obstacles. Now, the smoother you can be and the faster you can be getting off your bike and running through the obstacles and getting back on your bike, taking really the least amount of steps possible, the faster you're going to be over the whole course. Cyclocross started in Europe, and it was really just a tactic to be able to ride your bike in the winter and not freeze to death, not freeze your feet. So they'd build a course and they'd put barriers in that would force you off your bike and force you to run short sections of the course, and that would keep your feet warm and also keep the average speed down so you didn't have such a wind chill.
In Europe, cyclocross has real deep tradition, but it's developed over there into a major business, and cyclocross racers in Europe can make, you know, $60,000-$70,000 just in starts alone.
Cha-ching!
You're really cha-ching!
In Santa Cruz here, we're paying every weekend through blood and sweat.
This is from today. All the blood's gone, but you usually get a few red badge of courage from cross race. There's a lot of different factions within the small cyclocross world. There are people who are cyclocross traditionalists, which ride a pure cyclocross bike, which basically looks like your average road bike with knobby tires. And there are people on full-on mountain bikes.
It's a big issue right now on whether or not people want to let the mountain bikers competing with the cyclocross riders, because there's a lot of the traditional cyclocross people who we're winning the races constantly, and now the mountain bikes are getting so high-tech and lightweight that mountain bikes are, you know, winning the races. And so it's a big issue on whether or not you do a totally separate category.
People ride all kinds of bikes, and it's pretty much a freak show.
I'm probably foaming at the mouth.
I like cyclocross. It's just all out, gut-wrenching, everything you have on the line, and it takes a lot of coordination, agility, and some grace, and I like having that all come together.
It's just got its own identity, and people are into it because of the passion for the sport. It's a whole different identity.
Okay, we're warmed up. Let's race.
I ain't scared of that little thing. Sort of scared of the smell, though.
Drop of the wood.
Yeah! Ah!
Goes to show, man versus machine, man versus animal. Takes an animal to win. Really done.
Quitting time!
You know what's great about having 140 acres? You can come out here and just go,
ah!
And nobody hears you, nobody sees you. It's a beautiful thing.